Hey guys, Willow Lewis here, and today we have got another the Match Day vlog for you guys. It is Saturday, it is the Premier League, it is Manchester United versus Wolverhampton Wanderers. And let's have a look at some facts about our visitors this afternoon. Have a look at the form guide going into today's game. I'll bring you to your news around about an hour before kickoff. And today's referee is Paul Tierney. And here is the weather forecast down at Old Trafford this afternoon. So kickoff this afternoon is at 5:30. It will give us a chance to see our new signing, Bruno Fernandes from Sporting Lisbon. Yes, guys, let's do this on another Match Day vlog. Come on, United! Right, guys, we're in the car on the way to Old Trafford. Wolves' fourth game of the season in all competitions against them. What do you think?
Yeah, it seems to be. We play them every other week. Following on from disappointment against City, it's been a bit of a excitement in the transfer window, if you want to call it excitement.
Yeah.
Bruno Fernandes giving a bit of zest to our depleted midfield. And obviously the strange happenings last night, which was Odion Ighalo, the 30-year-old ex-Premier League player who we're now paying a quarter of his wages for to play for the next 6 months at a cost of about $3 million. So our plan A was obviously to sign Haaland, but that didn't happen. He went elsewhere and we didn't have a plan B. So it's like going to a shop at Christmas and picking up whatever you can before Christmas Day, before everything runs out, regardless of what it is. And it's for a relative that you don't really like, and you think, yeah, that'll do. And that's what it feels like with Ighalo.
Just desperate, I call it desperate.
Seems a bit of a desperation call to me, all of a sudden.
Because he was banging them in four or five years ago.
For Watford, and then he was greedy. Went off to China on his $300,000 a week or whatever. Suddenly wants to come back to the Premier League. Because obviously don't come back with the coronavirus, but the logic doesn't make a lot of sense. Obviously a stopgap and backup for Greenwood and Martial and while Rashford's injured, etc. But yeah, I might prove me wrong and bang a load of goals and be a bit of a Zlatan concert, but it's a strange one.
Anyway, what's your prediction?
Anyway, moving on to today. A tough one to predict, really. Wolves are, as we know, they don't get hammered 3 or 4-0. It's generally quite tight. If we win, we're about 4 points behind Chelsea after they've just drawn 2-2 against Leicester. And similarly, if the Wolves win, they'll go ahead of us. Obviously we could drop down to 7th or 8th depending on the results around us, so tough one. I'm sticking 1-1. I'm still thinking it might be a draw, but I'm going to go for a 2-1 United. Going to be positive. 2-1 United.
I'm going to take your first prediction. I'm going to go for 1-1 today. I'm going to go for a draw.
It could be the odd goal, Half me was thinking it could be 0-0 or 1-0, but maybe Fernandes, he won't start though. He could come on at about 60th minute.
And do what Martial did against Liverpool.
Yeah, please welcome our new signing, Bruno Fernandes, great team, Bruno Fernandes. And that'll be like 10-15 minutes of getting used to it. So I don't know if he's going to influence the game to any great degree. But let's see.
So I'm going to go for 1-1 purely because because, well, we beat Wolves, didn't we, in the FA Cup replay, third round.
Yeah.
How long was it, 2 weeks ago?
Yeah, yeah.
And I think they'll want revenge. They're a good team, organised, got good players like Traore and Jimenez, so defence have to be on good watch. Yeah, I'm going to go for 1-1.
Yeah.
Today starting 11, so we've got De Gea, Wan-Bissaka, Lindelof, Maguire who's captain, Shaw, Fred, Andreas, Mata, Bruno Fernandes is starting, James and Martial. On the bench we've got Romero, Dallo, Jones, Williams, Lingard, Chong and Greenwood. A promising team with Fernandes in there. Let's head on the bridge, let's head to Old Trafford.
Where have you been? I know where you've been. You've been tax dodging, haven't you?
No matter where I've been, I'm a celebrity. Get me out of here.
I say you what, if you go behind there, you're in the water. You're in the drink, son.
I know.
How's your holiday?
Smashing, yeah.
You look well. I do. You look well, or you've been in some dodgy tanning place in Salford. Tell the truth.
Well, I'm not now. You shouldn't tempt me.
Was it good? Did you enjoy it?
Hey,
was the sun shiny for you?
Yeah, it was actually. Yeah. But I tell you what, it was cold when the sun went in. Yeah. When the cloud came up, it was cold.
You'd take that above this though, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
You'd be seasick on it, don't you?
I know, yeah. I've got my leopard skin long johns on at the minute.
Oh, go on. No, don't show me.
Doesn't that?
The suspense is killing me. All right, we'll let you.
I'm going now. That's now you.
Yeah, I'm off after that.
I've kept the rain off for you so far.
Who's Lorraine?
Hey?
Lorraine who?
Oh, what am I need?
I know, yeah, it's over.
Fasten your jersey up, yeah. Oh.
See you later.
See you later.
Claire, Bruno Fernandes starts.
Well, yeah, I've already sold out of scarves. Bruno Fernandes. Yeah. Scarves sold out
Bruno
already,
Radio.
That's wonderful.
Yeah.
Wolves again.
Tight. It's going to be tight.
How many times have we played them now? After
I know,
count?
Yeah.
Is this number four? Okay.
Residents.
Okay, well, let's hope. We absolutely stuff them.
Lifestyle.
I'm going for 3-0. I'm going for a very optimistic.
I'm throwing the boat out there.
3-0.
Yeah.
I think they'll throw Bruno on.
He's playing, starting.
In the 55th minute.
He's starting. Yeah.
That has surprised me. I thought they'd throw him on a couple of minutes
before the protest walkout. Yeah, will they?
Everyone had changed their mindset.
Are they
going to walk out?
Will they walk out?
Not enough.
There was an attempted walkout last match, but it.
Yeah. New player, Fernandes, bit more excitement. Do you think people will still go?
I hope so. I've been watching a lot of footage of him playing.
Yeah.
And he does look.
Yeah, stick around and watch it. Support the team.
It can be very special.
Yeah,
but as you know, this can be the graveyard for strikers. So
we've just got Martial and James up.
Let's hope he comes good, and let's hope he's here for a long time. and let's have another superstar.
Right, guys, Claude is at the rugby, so he's not here today, but he's left us a faithful message.
As you know, 23 people lost their lives in that terrible tragedy in 1958, including 8 players and 3 members of staff. We welcome family members of those involved in the match this evening. Old Trafford, please remember all those affected as we listen to the Flowers of Manchester.
Manchester United line up this afternoon.
Number one, David De Gea. Number two, Victor Lindelof. Number five, the captain, Harry Maguire. Number eight, Juan Mata. Number nine, Anthony Martial. Number 15, Andreas Pereira. Number 17, Fred. And welcome 18, Rio.
Not the greatest half of football you'll ever see. Players on the ground most of the time.
Yeah, especially Martial.
Martial is just disappointing. Yeah. He's so lazy to watch, isn't he? See no movement from him. You know, Bruno's looked lively. He's, you know, he wants to get the ball. He wants to give and go. You know, he's had a couple of minor attempts, but there's been nothing really.
We
go forward and then we either go into people or we lose the ball.
Yeah.
You know, like we all say, there's no end product, but yeah. I think the team most likely are Wolves. You know, they've got the ball over and left us a bit exposed on a couple of occasions, but there's been nothing really. Yeah. There's been no shots of great worth for both teams, really. So I don't think any of our predictions will come right today, and it's the second half totally different. So, disappointment in obviously James. Needs to show a bit more. You know, he goes on the ground and expects a foul, and it doesn't work like that always. So, yeah, overall, yeah, I'd say we need to be better the second half.
Manchester United 0, Wolverhampton 1-0. disappointing result for sure. First half, I think Wolves had slightly better position. They had the better chances. We didn't really have any shots, really. But that is a surprise touch and some nice long balls out to Daniel James' attack. But no fear factor was there for the Wolves' defence. Second half, majority, we were all over them, but we just couldn't put it in the back of the net. Our first play is good, but then the final ball is just not good enough, and that's what lacks us today. I think that's what lacks the majority of days as well. So yes guys, this is now the winter break. I'll see you later on another World Most Match Day vlog. Take care, like and subscribe, and I'll see you later. Have a good one. Sum up after home draw. Don't get many nil nils, do we? But it's happened today. Manchester United nil, Wolverhampton Wanderers nil. What do you make of it?
Gave him a few chances, wasn't it, really? Fernandes, decent debut.
Yeah.
I think what he did was alright. You know, he just got to settle in and he was trying a few little passes, trying to break people through, but unfortunately, the likes of Pereira and Martial were very poor today, and also James.
You have to bear in mind that Fernandes isn't surrounded by the likes of, say Messi or Ronaldo?
He's surrounded by average midfielders.
Yeah,
he's surrounded by, the players who really aren't
that great.
United players, should we say. He must feel a bit frustrated.
Yeah.
Martial was poor today.
Falling over too easily. James falling over too easily.
Yeah. I wouldn't be surprised. He's not a United player for me.
He's been here for long enough.
Yeah. And it's just not working. You get his odd game where I'll get a couple of goals, but there's no consistency in his play. And he's frustrated to watch. When Rashford comes back and Fernandes has got someone to feed on to, and maybe Ighalo will cause a few problems, but at the minute you wonder where the sort of goals are coming from.
I think the Rashford has killed the vibe, if you like.
We've only had 4 points out of the last five games.
I'm not saying that Rashford's going to change the game, but he's the one that could score your goals.
Out of what we've got, Greenwood Martial and Rashford's the one that's been banging them in.
Yeah. I think the popper isn't there, doesn't give that midfield strength either.
We've only won in Premier League four points out of the last five games. We're not top four, not top four quality, so it's difficult to see where we're going to end up. Chelsea dropping points, they're struggling to score. They're not struggling to score, they do score, but it's proven that obviously Rudiger got two goals, and he's not a striker, is he?
He's a defender, centre-back.
And obviously Matic scored midweek, he's an attacker, is he? So
anyway, he drops off the goals.
It's the attacking situation maybe Ighalo will put a few in.
I don't want to get our hopes up because use Sanchez as an example. We brought him off Arsenal, he was great at Arsenal. He banned the bin, skills, long range shots, came to United, what did he do? That's the worry with new signings, because you have to fit in to that style of play.
You've got to get on with your manager and people's body language, says a lot. Marshall's is, I don't know why he wears gloves, really.
That annoys you, doesn't it?
Actually, he does wear gloves because he doesn't run enough to get his hands warm. Maybe that's it. But I think the winter break couldn't come soon enough because I think I've had enough of watching United over the last few weeks. Certainly a break's good.
I don't necessarily think we need to sign new players, but our style of play needs to change, because Leicester, when they won the league that season, their team wasn't that great. You know, they don't. Yeah, they didn't have what Liverpool's team is now, or City.
Yeah, you can work,
but it was their style of play that won it.
Yeah,
so
you can tell us. Yeah, you don't have to have superstars.
Oh. You have to just change your style of play.
Yeah, but obviously then you start pointing the finger at Ollie and tactics and such like. So Pogba will probably move on. I've got to fill some shoes there, and with Tomine's coming back, but he's not world class, is he?
Yeah.
But something's gonna have to change.
Whether or not
Ollie's given that time or not, I don't know.
But you can't build a team with average players, we've seen that.
You can, but you can't make them into world class players. You're not gonna suddenly turn Andres Pereira
into a
world class player. Winter break, and then it's Chelsea, and back onto the next vlog will be Watford on the 23rd on Sunday, so that's our next match vlog. So anyway, that's it.
See you later, guys. Take care,
have a good winter break.